Today I'll be reviewing the Yealink Room Panel, certified for Microsoft Teams, of course. I'm Paul Bloom, and you're watching In My Humble Opinion. This is Yealink's Android-driven room panel. It's an 8-inch all-in-one scheduling panel, and it has loads of options. On the sides over here, LED strips, which light up depending on your status. Turning it over, you'll see we've got Ethernet in the back there. We've got power. You can either run it over PoE, or you can individually power it. It also has the option to connect over Wi-Fi, which is fine. It's not running audio or video. It's just connectivity, so that should be fine. Just powering it up, the Yealink logo pops up real quick. Now, whilst that's loading, just to point out that this device, like any of the Yealink kit, comes with everything in the box. Every mounting bracket, every screwdriver, every little piece you need. I would just want to go through the initial setup, and that'll allow me to switch over to dim the screen a little so it's easier to read. Now, whilst I'm going through that over there, whether you mount this guy on jib, on glass, on concrete, it doesn't really matter. It even has an option to mount within a power box within the wall. So really, really well thought out. I might just try a quick sign in just to show you that obviously I need network to connect. So here we go. Where's my error? There we go. There's my error, basically saying that I need to be connected to the network. So I hit the little cog over there to go back into settings. I'm going to go into the admin settings. The admin password required is 4 zeros. I didn't find that anywhere on the box information and so on that came with the kit. But I'll just go down to my display over there and just turn the brightness down a bit. And hopefully, yep, camera can pick up the visuals way better. Now, while I'm in here, probably a good idea to turn on my Wi-Fi network, which is disabled by default. So here we go, Wi-Fi network, turn that on, just find my wireless network over there. And just connecting into my wireless network and done. Right, so whilst that's connecting, just tell you a little bit about the actual account. So we're actually using, or we will be using, the exact same credentials we used for the MTR, so the Microsoft Teams Room system. In my case, my account's called HBC for Hibiscus Coast, if you were wondering, and I'm using the exact same credentials. Now, according to the official documentation, you would need to have a Microsoft Teams Room license associated with that account to be able to sign in to the wall panel. Now, I do not have one of those. Now, don't take that as gospel that you can get around that. What I do have instead is just E3, because that's all I have in my test tenant. So I've got an E3 license assigned. I've got a Logi Rally bar signed in with that account already as my room system, and I'm just adding the tap to that. Of course, I often come across people who've added an E3 or an E5 license for a meeting room use. It's an overkill, folks. Don't do that. You're wasting money. You don't need to do that. And there we go. We're signed in. Good to go. Now, you'll notice just changing gears really quickly as I can scroll up and down there and have a look at the different time slots and the availability of the room. I can also reserve straight from the unit. So current time 2:45, it shows me in little increments. I can up that to 3 and then just scroll to see other time frames moving forward and come back again. Now, if I were to reserve that, that'll make it busy and it'll actually block it out in the calendar as well, which is brilliant. No one else will be able to grab that slot because it's booked out. How cool is that? Let's jump back into settings and see what else we can do. Just going in there, remember that the default admin password is 40, so anything under the admin section will require us to log in with those credentials. So 40s, off we go. We'll be changing that, obviously, and then just have a look. Basic settings, we can change the volume, we can turn the LEDs on or off, or their brightness. Flick over to time and date. I might make a few changes here. 24-hour mode is my preference. Maybe the date format's a bit odd for me. I prefer day, month, year. I'll choose that format over there. And as you're making these adjustments, they're automatically done on the fly. Adaptive displays to adjust the lighting based on how bright it is in the room. Not really something that I found worked for me, not the behavior I wanted. Looking at network, network status, network settings, we can change DNS, we can turn off DHCP, go static, all that kind of stuff. Bit of diagnostic information as well here, where you can ping and trace route and that sort of stuff. If you're having some connectivity issues, that's quite handy to know. So I'll just do a quick ping of the Google DNS servers. Yep, that seems to work perfectly. And of course, if we go here to Wi-Fi, we'll see some additional information, which is quite handy. You can see our signal strength, the channel that was picked up. We can see security mode, transmit rate, frequency, all that kind of stuff. But this is cool. Check out panel apps. We've got wallpapers, which is the wallpaper on the room panel or the background. And I'm just going to change that. And LED settings, which are quite handy. At the moment, you can go red or purple for LED color. That's your busy color, right? So as you can see there, so I'll just change it red, purple. I prefer red actually for busy. And out we go. So currently you can't load your own backgrounds just yet, but watch this space. I'm sure that'll change soon. Let's now have a look at our Microsoft Teams admin portal and see what we can do over there. Now that I'm in the M365 portal, you can see my Android room system there using the same account, that HPC account that I've also now used to log into the panel. And you can see just below the Teams rooms on Android in the side over there, also panels, there's the panel as well. So that too can now be managed and is visible here. I didn't have to do anything for that, just logged in with the account and the rest was auto magic. So that's my review of the Yealink booking panel or the room scheduling panel. It's a good unit. It does exactly what it says on the box. It's easy to manage, easy to deploy. It looks the part and it's built to last. It's not very expensive. So when you look at a lot of the sort of subscription services that you can get where you can actually buy the hardware that I've seen on those is typically two times at least as expensive as what this little unit is. And also very typically there are some ongoing costs for the licensing of these units. And so in this case, fair to say, if you're putting them up where you already have MTR systems in play, there is no additional charge, just buy the hardware and that's it. I would have to say though that there is a case for putting these up in other areas where you don't have an MTR, but I'll leave that up to you. Thank you for watching. I'm Paul Bloom and this has been another episode of In My Humble Opinion.